Tequila, the only spirit that teaches us to take life with a grain of salt, a slice of lime, and a shot of its unmistakable content. Typically drank in shots and known as means to a great party, or for many, a bad hangover. From the dictionary definition, tequila is a spirit that is distilled in Mexico from an agave plantation and forms the basis of many mixed drinks. What is an agave, you may ask? Or why is real tequila only made in Mexico? My name is Jose Jimenez, and together you and I will take a journey to find out more about this spirit rich in culture and learn why agave is the cultivation of tradition. To fully understand to enjoy tequila, we have to learn to appreciate every aspect of every step of the process, from the cultivation of the agave plant to the barrels where the tequila is añejado or aged. The tequila making process is not just a process undertaken by machinery, but the distillation of tequila is an exact process intertwined by art and science that requires the care and labor of the experienced and passionate hands of the people working to create this unique spirit. The tequila starts with the grounds. Real tequila, like champagne, has a denomination of origin, which means it can only come from a specific part of the world. For the tequila, that place is on the west coast of Mexico in a small town named Tequila, Jalisco, town from which the liquor receives its name. According to historians, the use of the agave plant dates back to about 1580, when one of these plants was struck by lightning and cooked the inside of the agave, causing the juice to seep out. Seeing as how it was sweet and mildly alcoholic, the Aztecs believed the drink to be a gift from the gods that opened communication between mortals and them.
Somos de esta hermosa población, Tequila, Jalisco, está pegado a las faldas del Cerro de Tequila, el Cerro de Tequila. Yo digo que era un volcán, los que saben, los historiadores dicen que es un volcán inactivo. La cosa es que de ahí viene un agua de manantial, un agua rodada de la piedra volcánica, un agua muy pura, que es la que se utiliza pues, para todo el proceso de agua. Soy originario de este pueblo hermoso que es Tequila, Jalisco. Y aquí soy yo, aquí nació también mi papá, mi abuelito. Yo soy la cuarta generación continua en el negocio del tequila. Ya Eduardo, mi hijo, es la quinta generación, llevamos cinco generaciones trabajando en esta fábrica chiquita, el llano. Aquí ha sido la escuela de todo, ¿no? Aquí la estamos trabajando entre nosotros, también la trabajó mi papá, tiempo atrás aquí empezó mi abuelito, y aquí se fue a entrar en la fábrica grande, pero aquí, ¿sí? Mis tíos también, mis tíos abuelos, aquí fue la fábrica pionera donde nos enseñamos todos a trabajar, amar esta industria. Amar y conocer todas las bondades de esta gran bebida que es el tequila. Y lo más importante, aprender, vivir, convivir y amar qué es lo que hay atrás de una botella, qué es lo que hay atrás de la etiqueta.
The soul of the tequila is the agave plant, and the quality of the liquor is determined by the care given to the plant through its cultivation. The more mature the plant is, the fuller the taste will be. Some agave plants may even take up to 13 years to fully ripen. At time of harvest, the jimadores take out every plant by hand. The leaves are then cut, leaving just the heart of the plant, which is called the pineapple, due to its similarity in look with the fruit. After the harvest, the pineapples are delivered to distilleries. There, they are broken up into smaller pieces and only the best of these pieces are sent to ovens. After being cooked by vapor for about 72 hours in massive ovens, the pineapples are taken through a series of shredders and pressers, ejecting a juice to which an exact amount of water is added. The mix created is sent to the fermentation tanks, where a special house mix of yeast aids the fermentation process and makes sure that the quality of the tequila is maintained as pure and natural as it allows. Once the juice has been adequately fermented, it is ready to be distilled. Each variety of tequila usually goes through a double distillation that extracts all the impure elements and creates a smooth and refined drink. The process may seem simple, but tequila distillation is a science that only some maestros can exercise. The maestro controls every aspect of the distillation process personally and leaves no mistake. The final step in achieving the various different flavors of each tequila variation requires a different lapse of time. The tequila blanco is bottled as soon as the distillation is complete. The reposado is aged for about 8 months inside oak barrels. The añejo is approximately aged 18 months. Once the tequila has gone through the different flavor and quality tests, it is bottled and taken from Tequila Jalisco to a growing number of countries across the globe.
Pues mira, el tequila se aprecia a través de los órganos sentidos, ¿no? O sea, básicamente no te lo vas a untar, o sea, te vas a beber. Entonces viene desde la vista, vas a ver su color, vas a ver su textura, su concentración, su textura, su cuerpo, sus lágrimas y piernas, cómo se van escurriendo. Estás disfrutando el color y la textura del tequila. Después sus aromas, básicamente es la parte más rica. Que vas a apreciar sus aromas tan complejos que tiene, que es muy compleja la parte organoléctrica de los congéneres que tiene el tequila. Estar disfrutando el aroma y finalmente pues el gusto, ¿no? Ponerlo en boca, no pasárselo inmediatamente, disfrutarlo, ver su parte de la dulzura, la sapidez, la parte hasta astringente, la parte de la amargura. Después de que se pasa el tequila, hace una expiración lenta por la nariz y percibe sus aromas retroolfatorios, que son muy típicos los aromas de las especias, como pimientas, como canelas. Entonces, esa es la manera como puede disfrutar.
The agave plant plays much a larger role than just being the source of an alcoholic drink. Its leaves are harvested for a hemp-like fiber that is used for mats, clothing, rope, and paper. The plant was amply described as el árbol de las maravillas, or the tree of marbles, in a 1596 history of the Indians of Central America. Agaves are exotic drought-tolerant plants with an amazing structure. Very few spirits are made organically and or from a plant that can be utilized in many different ways.
Hola, mi nombre es Norma Macías. Estamos en la empresa que se llama Fibras, fábrica de papel artesanal. Nosotros aquí tenemos 17 años trabajando con este proyecto que es pues básicamente hacer papel con los residuos del tequila, que es el bagazo o comúnmente conocido aquí en tequila como marrano. Como escucharon, así le llaman muchas personas. Y bueno, hacemos de un residuo algo, digamos, funcional. Y aparte, fue muy lindo, ¿no? Digo, ¿qué puedo decir yo? Que me encanta lo que hago y me encanta lo que se puede lograr, ¿no? Desde una simple hoja para impresión o para escribir lo que quiera, hasta ahora lo que es joyería, invitación, sobres, o sea, todo, ¿no? Y crear un poquito la conciencia de cuidar un poquito, ¿no? Todo lo que es la onda mental. También entramos por ahí un poquito. Pues aprovechamos un residuo y aparte es un producto ecológico.
Although some tequilas have remained as family-owned brands, most well-known tequila brands are owned by large multinational corporations. However, there are over 100 distilleries making over 600 brands of tequila in Mexico, and over 200 brand names have been registered. According to the Tequila Regulation Council, the United States is Mexico's main client for this unique liquor and has been breaking records in consumption every year since 1995. It is time to return tequila to its rightful place on the upper shelves of our mental liquor cabinet. Respect the history and incredibly laborious process behind something that too often spends too little time on the tip of our tongues. Tequila, aside from tradition, taste, and aroma, means development, a noble distillation of great value, character, and extraordinary dimensions. A drink that writes its own history and gives us the opportunity to live through it.
¿Cómo no lo he de saber si en el camino me crié? ¿Cómo no lo he de saber?